Seatbelts, everyone! Please let this be a normal field trip. With a friend?
No way!
Cruising on down Main Street, you're relaxed and feeling good.
Yeah.
Next thing that you know, you'll see it.
Octopus in my neighborhood.
Surfing on a sound wave, swinging through the stars.
Yeah.
Take a left at your intestine.
Ambulance.
So strap your bones right to the seat. Come on in and don't be shy.
Come on.
Just to make your day complete. You might get baked into a pie. On the magic
ambulance.
It's a wild ride.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, Miss Frizzle.
Today, we're going to talk about cellular respiration and why we need oxygen to live. Yes, Ralphie?
What is cellular respiration?
I'm going to show you. And that's cellular respiration.
This is just making my head do circles.
Ralphie!
That's okay, class. Let's go on a field trip to help us learn.
Where are we going?
We're going deep into the cells of our bodies. Everybody quick to the magic ambulance!
Let's go!
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Stop on our field trip of cellular respirations would be in the cytoplasm. Is everybody ready?
Yeah!
Alright, seatbelts on, it's gonna be a bumpy ride.
No!
Cytoplasm. This is where glycolysis happens.
Hey Frizz, what's glycolysis?
Hey, it's a good thing you asked. Look out the window, it's happening right now.
Oh, look!
The first step of cellular respiration is glycolysis. Glycolysis occurs during the anaerobic phase inside the cell. More specifically, it's created in the cytoplasm. During glycolysis, a 6-carbon glucose molecule breaks down into 2 3-carbon pyruvic acid molecules and creates 2 ATP, which is then carried into the aerobic phase.
Frizz, what's ATP?
Ralphie!
ATP is adenosine triphosphate. It's the highest source of energy that our body uses.
I get it, Frizz. Glycolysis produces 2 out of 36 ATP.
But Frizz, what happens after glycolysis?
Well, the next step is the Krebs cycle.
The next phase is the aerobic phase, or Krebs cycle. This phase is still occurring inside the cell, but more specifically in the mitochondria, better known as the powerhouse cell because it takes on the more extensive workload. Here we will follow just one of the pyruvic acid molecules through the rest of the cycle. The pyruvic acid molecule will combine with the amino acid and a fatty acid molecule to form a coenzyme A molecule. The coenzyme A will enter the mitochondria and become part of the citric acid cycle.
Miss Frizz, where do the rest of the ATPs come from?
The rest of the 34 ATP comes from the citric acid cycle and electron transport chain.
In the citric acid cycle, high energy electrons are created who then combine with oxygen and enter the electron transport chain. The electron transport chain produces water and carbon dioxide as well as energy. Energy creates heat along with 34 ATP from the electron transport chain, and this combined with 2 ATP from glycolysis gives us a grand total of 36 ATP.
Go.
All right, class, that concludes our field trip. Everybody out of the magic ambulance.
Okay, class, that was cellular respiration. Hope you guys had a good field trip. Any questions?
Yes, Kenny?
What is cellular respiration?
You're smiling, dude. What is that?
Yeah.
They got their seatbelts on.
Yeah.
Know where your exits are at all times. Here we go. No, for real.
What happens after glycolysis?
Frizz.
What
happens?
The rest of 34 ATP comes from the citric acid cycle as long as.
Ron Burgundy. going out, first dates are usually just real awkward for me.